Hi students, this is the third video of multiple choice questions from the chapter Motion in a Straight Line. Let's move on to the first question. Two persons A and B are walking with speed 4 km per hour and 5 km per hour respectively in the same direction. The distance between B and after 3 hours will be, options are A 0.3 meter, B 30 meter, C 3000 meter, D 300 meter. Here you have to find the distance from person B to person A after a time of 3 hours. After a time of 3 hours, person B will be ahead of person A. Here the speed of person A and B are given, that are 4 km per hour and 5 km per hour. So here first you have to find the relative velocity of B, person B, with respect to person A. So that is VBA, which is equal to VB minus VA. VB and VA are given, that are 5 km per hour and 4 km per hour. So 5 minus 4 gives 1 km per hour. So next you have to find the distance using time 3 hours and this relative velocity of 1 km per hour. You know the formula, that is velocity is equal to distance displacement by time, or speed is equal to distance by time. So using that relation you can find the distance x, which is equal to velocity into time. So here velocity means relative velocity of person B with respect to person A. So distance of person B ahead of person A in time of t, here t is 3 hours, so x is equal to VBA into t. VBA, that is 1 km per hour, and time is 3 hours, 1 into 3. So answer, that is distance, you get it as 3 km, that means in terms of meter. So here 3, it is in kilometer. If you convert this kilometer distance from kilometer to meter, you get a answer as 3000 meter. So the answer is option C, 3000 meter. Second question. Train S is moving towards north with a speed of 25 meter per second. A monkey is moving with a speed of 5 meter per second on the loop of train S against its motion. The speed of the monkey as seen by the observer on the ground will be, option A 30 meter per second towards north, option B 30 meter per second towards south, option C 20 meter per second towards north, option D 20 meter per second towards south. So here you have to find the speed of the monkey as seen by the observer on the ground. Here you know the speed of train. Here monkey is moving on the loop of train against the motion of train. Yes. So here train is moving with a speed of 25 meter per second and monkey moving with a speed of 5 meter per second. So first you have to find the speed of monkey as seen by the observer on the ground. So that is here the speed of train, that is 25, and the speed of monkey is 5, that two are moving in opposite direction. So 25 minus 5 gives 20 meter per second towards north. So the answer is option C, 20 meter per second towards north. Third question. The displacement of a particle is given by y is equal to a plus b t plus c t square minus d t to the power 4. The initial velocity and acceleration are respectively, options are a b comma minus 4d, option b minus b comma 2c, option c बी कमा टू सी, ऑप्शन डी टू सी कमा माइनस फोर डी. हियर द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ पार्टिकल इज गिवन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इक्वेशन, दैट इज वाई इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी टी प्लस सी टी स्क्वायर माइनस डी टी टू द पावर फोर. हियर यू नीड टू फाइंड द इनिशियल वेलोसिटी एंड एक्सेलरेशन. सो यू नो द फॉर्मूला, दैट इज वाई इज इक्वल टू वी नॉट टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वायर. सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट, हियर वाई इज डिस्प्लेसमेंट, you know the formula of displacement in terms of initial velocity and a. If you compare this equation, given equation, with this, then you get the initial velocity v naught as b and acceleration as 2c. While comparing these two equation, you get v naught as b and a as 2c. So the answer is option C, that is B, initial velocity B and acceleration 2C. Fourth question, a body covers a distance of 5 meter along a semicircular path. The ratio of distance to displacement is, options are A 11:7, B 12:5, C 8:3, D 7:5. Here, body covers a distance of 5 meter along a circular path. Here, body is moving in a circular path. Here, you have to find the ratio of distance to displacement of a body. You know the formula for distance and displacement. So, distance covered by a body while moving in a semicircular path, that is 2 pi r by 2, that is half of the circumference. Circumference formula, that is 2 pi r. So half of this, so 2 pi r divided by 2 and divide by displacement. Displacement, here diameter gives the displacement. Displacement means it is the shortest distance. So here diameter in terms of radius, that is 2 into r. Formula for diameter, that is 2 into r. So which is equal to, while simplifying this, you get, here 2 gets cancels, remaining is pi r in the numerator, in the denominator 2 into r. So here r also cancels, remaining is pi by 2. So pi value, that is 22/7 into 2. Here 2 becomes, while going to numerator, it becomes half. So 22/7 into half. So while simplifying, you get 11:7. So the answer is option A, that is 11:7. Fifth question, a car traveling at 58 km per hour overtakes another car traveling at 40 km per hour. Assuming each car to be 5 meter long, the time for overtaking is, options are 200 seconds, B 2 minutes, C 20 seconds, D 2 seconds. Here, a car that is traveling with a speed of 58 km per hour and this car overtakes another car and that car is moving with the speed of 40 km per hour. So, here you have to find the time for overtaking this vehicle, this car, which is moving with the speed of 40 km per hour by this car that is moving with a speed of 58 km per hour. So here first you have to find the relative velocity of this car with respect to here, this car, another car which is traveling at 40 km per hour. That is relative velocity, which is equal to 58 minus 40. So which gives 18 km per hour. Convert this to meter per second because here answers are given in seconds. So convert the unit from kilometer per hour to meter per second. So that is 18 into 5 by 18, which gives 5 meter per second. So next you can find the time. So you know velocity is equal to x by t. So from there t is equal to distance or x by v. So you know the distance traveled. Here the two cars are 5 meter long. So total distance, that is 5 meter plus 5 meter, that is 10 meter. So total distance traveled 5 plus 5, 10 meter. And time for overtaking, which is equal to time, that is equal to distance by velocity. Distance is 10 and relative velocity, that is 5. So 10 by 5, which is equal to 2 seconds. So the answer is option D, 2 seconds. Sixth question. A train 200 meter long crosses a bridge 300 meter long. It enters the bridge with a speed of 30 meter per second and leaves it with a speed of 50 meter per second. What is the time taken to cross the bridge? Options are A, 2.5 seconds. Option B, 7.5 seconds. Option C, 12.5 seconds. Option D, 15 seconds. Here, a train of length 200 meter crosses a bridge of length 300 meter, and the train enters the bridge with a speed of 30 meter per second, means initial speed of train 30 meter per second, and the train leaves the bridge with a speed of 50 meter per second. That means it, here 50 meter per second is the final speed, final velocity of train. What is the time taken to cross the bridge? Here you have to find the time taken by the train to cross the bridge. So here you know V naught, V, and the total distance traveled by the train while crossing the bridge. So total distance covered while crossing the bridge, that is length of train plus length of bridge, that gives the total distance, that is 500 meter. So next, using this distance, initial speed, final speed, you have to find the time. You know the relation, final velocity, that is equal to initial velocity plus A into T. That means V is equal to V naught plus A into T. That gives the relation of V naught, V and T. But there you don't know the value of A, acceleration. So first you have to find the acceleration A using V, V naught, and this total distance. That is using the relation V square is equal to V naught square plus 2AX. So using this relation, first you have to find the acceleration. So here V square means 50 square, that is 2500, minus V naught square. V naught is 30. 30 square means 900. 2500 minus 900, that is equal to 2 into A into X. Here X is 500. So 2A into 500. While simplifying this, you get acceleration as 1.6 meter per second square. So next, using this A, V naught and V, you can find the time T using the formula V is equal to V naught plus A T. So V value, that is 50, which is equal to 30 plus A value 1.6 into T. So while simplifying, you get a time as 12.5 seconds. So the answer is option C, 12.5 seconds. Seventh question. The displacement of a body along x-axis depends on time as square root of x, which is equal to t plus 1. Then the velocity of body, options are A, increases with time. Option B, decreases with time. Option C, independent of time. Option D, none of these. Here the displacement of body, that is given in the form of equation, that is square root of x, which is equal to t plus 1. So here you have to find the relation between velocity of body and time. So here first you have to find the velocity of body using the formula v is equal to dx by dt. So dx by dt means it is a differentiation of x with respect to time. So here you know the equation, that is square root of x which is equal to t plus 1. So rearrange this and get x is equal to t plus 1 whole square. So next to differentiate this x equation with respect to time. So in that case you get the answer as 2 into t plus 1. So here we are using a formula, that is differentiation of x to the power n with respect to x, that is equal to n into x to the power n minus 1. So here in place of x, here is t plus 1, and in place of n, here is 2. So while differentiating this, you get n means 2 into x, that is in place of x, here t plus 1. So 2 into t plus 1 to the power n minus 1. Here n is 2, 2 minus 1, that gives 1. So differentiation of this x means t plus 1 whole square becomes 2 into t plus 1. So you get velocity. Here dx by dt means v. So v is equal to 2 into t plus t. So here you get the equation of velocity. So from this equation you conclude that velocity, that is, increases with time. So here v and t are directly proportional. Velocity is directly proportional to time. So as v increases, t also increases. Velocity increases with time. So the answer is option A. Eighth question. When the speed of a car is v, the minimum distance over which it can be stopped is s. If the speed becomes n into v, what will be the minimum distance over which it can be stopped during same time? Options are A, s by n, option B, n into s, option C, s by n square, option D, n square into s. So here in this question, when the speed of a car is v, that is the initial speed of car is taken as v, the minimum distance over which it can be stopped is s. So here the finally that car stopped means that final velocity of car is 0 and the minimum distance it covered, that is s, that is taken as s. So using this initial speed v, final speed 0 and distance s, you have to find the acceleration. So there you get a acceleration in the form of equation. So you can use the formula v square is equal to v naught square plus 2ax, because you know v, v naught and x. So here v naught is v, so v naught square means v square, and final velocity is 0, so 0. So 0 is equal to v square plus 2 into a into x. Here x means distance. Here the minimum distance covered by that car is taken as s, so 2as. So from this you get a as minus v square by 2s. So here minus means negative acceleration. We can call this as a retardation. Negative acceleration is called as retardation. So acceleration, magnitude of acceleration, that is v square by 2s. Next, if the speed becomes nv, means initial speed of car become n into v, what will be the minimum distance over which it can be stopped? So here also that car stopped means their final velocity becomes 0. So here you have to find that minimum distance while changing the speed from nv to 0, and the acceleration, that is v minus v square by 2s. So using the same formula, that is v square is equal to v naught square plus 2ax, you can find the मिनिमम डिस्टेंस, सो दैट फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज जीरो बिकॉज दैट कार इज स्टॉप्ड एंड इनिशियल वेलोसिटी हियर एन इंटू वी, सो दिस वी नॉट बिकम एन इंटू वी प्लस 2 into a into x. A is this one. You got it as v square by 2s, and x is that you have to find. Okay. So you give, while rearranging this, you get x is equal to v naught square by 2a. So v naught means initial velocity, means initial speed. Here it is n into v. So substitute v naught as n into v divided by 2 into a. 2 into this. A v square by 2s. So while simplifying this, here in the denominator 2 gets cancels, then this s goes to numerator, then v naught v square cancels, remaining is n square into this s. So the answer is option D, that is n square into s. Ninth question. A thief is running away on a straight road in a jeep moving with a speed of 9 meter per second. A policeman chases him on a motorcycle moving at a speed of 10 meter per second. If the instantaneous separation of the jeep from the motorcycle is 100 meter, how long will it take for the policeman to catch the thief? Options are A 1 seconds, option B 19 seconds, option C 90 seconds, option D 100 seconds. Here a thief is running away on a straight road in a jeep moving with a speed of 9 meter per second, and policeman chases him on a motorcycle moving at a speed of 10 meter per second. So if the instantaneous separation, that is separation between the policeman and thief, their policeman moving on a motorcycle and thief is moving on a jeep, means separation between jeep from the motorcycle, that is given 100 meter. So here you have to find the time for the policeman to catch the thief. So for here, first you have to find the relative velocity. Relative velocity of policeman with respect to thief. So you know the formula, that is velocity of policeman minus velocity of thief. That is 10 minus 9. That gives 1 meter per second. So next, using this relative velocity and separation between jeep and motorcycle, that is 100 meters. So using this 100 meter and 1 second distance and velocity, you can find the time. You know the formula of speed, that is distance by time. So using that, you can find the time as distance by speed. So here distance is 100 meter, speed or velocity is 1. So 100 by 1. So you get time as 100 seconds. So 10th question. A bus is moving with a velocity 10 meter per second on a straight road. A scooterist wishes to overtake the bus in 100 second. If the bus is at a distance of 1 kilometer from the scooterist, with what velocity should the scooterist chase the bus? Options are A 50 meter per second, option B 40 meter per second, option C 30 meter per second, option D 20 meter per second. So let the velocity of scooter be v meter per second. Here velocity of scooter is not given, we take it as v, and velocity of bus is given, that is 10 meter per second, and a scooter is wishes to overtake the bus in 100 second. So this is the time, and the distance between scooterist and bus, that is 1 kilometer. Bus is at a distance of 1 kilometer from the scooterist. So here you have to find the velocity. with what velocity should the scooterist chase the bus? So you know the formula of velocity, which is equal to distance by time. So using that, here velocity means, that is velocity of scooterist with respect to bus. So there you get a formula as V minus 10, relative velocity of scooterist with respect to bus. That is V means velocity of scooterist minus velocity of bus, V minus 10. That gives the velocity of scooterist with respect to bus. So into time, which is equal to distance. So here time is 100 and distance is 1 kilometer. So in meter it becomes 1000. So V minus 10, that is the relative velocity of scooterist with respect to bus, into time 100, which is equal to 1000. So while simplifying this, you get a velocity of scooterist as 20 meter per second. So the answer is option D. 11th question. The area under acceleration time graph represents option A, the velocity, option B, displacement, option C, change in velocity, option D, distance traveled. The area under acceleration time graph. Acceleration time graph means that you are taking acceleration values along y axis and time values are along x axis. If you find the slope in this acceleration time graph, you will get the answer of change in velocity. So the answer is option C. 12th question. The velocity time graph of a body moving with uniform velocity is straight line. Options are A, parallel to x axis, option B, parallel to y axis, option C, inclined to x axis, option D, inclined to y axis. The velocity time graph, there we are taking velocity values along y axis and time values along x axis. Velocity time graph of a body moving with uniform velocity. For an object which is moving with the uniform velocity, so that velocity remains constant. So in this graph, velocity time graph, you get a straight line. So there you get a straight line, and that straight line, that is parallel to x axis, because as the time changes, velocity values remains same. So the answer is option A. 13th question. A car accelerated from initial position and then returned to initial point. Then options are A, velocity is 0 but speed increases. Option B, speed is 0 but velocity increases. Option C, both speed and velocity increases. Option D, both speed and velocity decreases. Here, a car accelerated from initial position and then returned to initial point. So here car is returned to initial point, that is accelerated from initial position, means initial point, and returned to that position. So here initial position and final position is same, so the displacement is 0. So if the displacement is 0, then velocity also 0. So velocity is 0, but speed increases because here car is accelerated. So the answer is option A, velocity is 0 but speed increases. 14th question. Thief's car is moving with a speed of 10 meter per second. A police van chasing this car with a speed of 5 meter per second fires a bullet at the thief's car with muzzle velocity 72 km per hour. Find the speed with which the bullet will hit the car. Options are A, 10 meter per second, option B, 20 meter per second, option C, 15 meter per second, option D, 25 meter per second. Here, speed of the thief's car, that is given 10 meter per second. So this is with respect to ground. And speed of policeman also given. A policeman chasing this car with a speed of 5 meter per second. So this is also with respect to ground. And fires a bullet at the thief's car with the muzzle velocity of 72 km per hour. So that is the speed of or velocity of bullet. So velocity of thief's car with respect to ground, that is VTG, which is equal to 10 meter per second. And velocity of police van with respect to ground, that is VPG, that is 5 meter per second. And then velocity of bullet fired by police van with respect to ground, that is VBG, which is equal to 72 km per hour. Convert this value to meter per second, because these values and answers are given in meter per second. So convert this value to meter per second, that is 72 into 5 by 18, that gives value in meter per second, that is 20 meter per second. So next you have to find the velocity with which the bullet will hit the target. So that is VBT, which is equal to VBG minus VTG. So VBG means velocity of bullet with respect to ground. So here bullet that is in police van. So there police fires a bullet. There bullet is inside the police van. So VBG that is equal to VBG plus VPG means velocity of bullet with respect to ground and velocity of police van with respect to ground, because here bullet that is also moving with the velocity of police van. So you have to add these two, then you get the velocity of bullet with respect to ground, that is VBG 20 plus VPG 5 meter per second minus VTG. So VTG means velocity of thief's car with respect to ground, that is minus 10. So while simplifying this, you get value as 25 minus 10, that gives 15 meter per second. So the answer is option C, 15 meter per second. 15th question. A train of 150 meter length is going towards north direction at a speed of 10 meter per second. A parrot flies at a speed of 5 meter per second towards south direction parallel to the railway track. The time taken by the parrot to cross the train is equal to, options are A, 12 seconds, option B, 8 seconds, option C, 15 seconds, option D, 10 seconds. So here length of train that is given, 150 meter, and that train is moving towards north direction and with the speed of 10 meter per second. Here speed of train 10 meter per second, and a parrot flies at a speed of 5 meter per second. Here the speed of parrot, which is given as 5 meter per second, but that parrot which is flies towards south direction, so opposite to the direction of train. Here you have to find the time taken by the parrot to cross the train. As the train and parrot are moving just in opposite direction, hence the relative velocity of parrot with respect to train, which is given by velocity of parrot minus velocity of train. Here train and parrot are moving in opposite direction, so velocity of parrot 10 minus into minus 5. So velocity of train, that is 5, but it is moving in opposite direction, so I taken this 5 in negative sign. So 10 minus of minus 5, which gives 15 meter per second. That is the relative velocity of parrot with respect to train. Next, you have to find the time. Time taken by the parrot to cross the train. You know the formula, that is velocity is equal to displacement by time. So from there you get time is equal to displacement by velocity. So here displacement means length of train, that is 150 meter divided by velocity. Here you get a relative velocity as 15 meter per second. So 150 by 15, so that gives answer as 10 seconds. So the answer is option D.